video, I am going to give you information about the advantage and limitation of accounting. This is the second part of the chapter number 1, that is accounting and its terminology. So there are the advantages of accounting. That's why we are writing books of account. So in that, very first advantages of accounting is availability of accounting information. That means as and when we are needed the accounting information, we can get it from the account. For example, let's say if we wanted to take a loan from the bank, bank will be asking our books of account. So if when we need the books of account, it will be readily available. So information can be given to bank for the bank loan. This is the first advantage of availability of accounting information. The second one is to know the profitability. In the business, whatever we are doing for the profit purpose. So from the account only we can come to know that we have done the profit or we have incurred the loss. So for the for knowing the profitability of the business, we are writing books of account. The third advantage is to know the financial status. In the business, when we are preparing final account, in final account we are preparing three accounts called trading account, profit and loss account, and balance sheet. So from the balance sheet, when we are checking the balance sheet, we can come to know that how many liability we supposed to pay. Liability word we have already discussed in part 1, that liability means the money that we supposed to pay to the other party. So if the business entity have to pay more liability, in that situation we can come to know that the financial status is weak, and if the liability is less, then we can come to know that financial status is strong for the business entity. So from the accounting information, we can come to know that what is the financial status of the business. The next is for tax planning. So as we know that whatever transaction we are doing, and from the income of the business, we supposed to pay the tax. So for the tax purpose, we have to write the books of account. And from the books of account, from the transaction, we can come to know that how much tax we supposed to pay, and we can make planning for that. So fourth advantages of writing books of account is to know the tax liability and for make the planning for that. The fifth number is a valuation of the business. Sometimes the business owner wants to sell his business. So for selling the business, there is a need of valuation of business. That means for how much the business is going to sell. For that, we need to know from the account that what are the profitability of the business, and from the profitability of the business, we can make the valuation of the business. So for that purpose also, we need to write the books of account, and from the books of account only we can know the selling price of the business. The next is a decision making. In the business, there are three type of business form. That is, very first is a sole proprietorship, second is a partnership, and the third one is a company form. So in all these form, there are the different stakeholders. Stakeholder means the people, they are interested in the business. So they are taking their own decision, like a stakeholder, like creditors, customer, employee, or some other, let's say bank, they are taking decision to continue with the business or not from the accounting. So for the stakeholder, they are also taking their own decision from the accounting information. The next advantages of accounting is as an evidence. When there is a dispute in a business, that dispute can be solved with the help of accounting only. So in the case of dispute, Account can be work as a evidence or proof, as we know that account is written on the base of principle and rules, and there is because of the principle and rules it is a reliable. So from that reliable source we can proof that the information whatever is written in that is a true. So at the time of dispute the account can work as a proof. So that is number 7. The number 8 is a comparison with the past operation. So in the business entity everybody is working for the profit. So whatever we have done the profit in the past, we can compare that profit with the present, and even we can come to know that in present we are developing or not. That means the business entity is developed or not. So that thing can be compared with the comparison can be done with the past operation, and the result can be come out. If any variation is there, that variation can be sort out with the help of the account only. Even comparison can be there with our rivals. So in business, when there is a competitor, comparison can be made with the competitor also with the help of account only. So here comparison with our past operation and comparison with our competitor also can be possible with the help of accounting only. The next is a moral control. As we know that account is a reliable thing, so employee and the other person knows that account is written in the business, so no one can make the fraud or no one can make any mistake. So to make a moral control over the employee, there is a need of writing books of account. Corrective measures. As we know in the business, due to some mistake business can suffer some losses. If that type of losses has been suffered in the business in the past, that can be a lesson for the business entity, and that cannot be recur again. For that, corrective measures can be done by the business entity with the help of accounting. So accounting is also as helpful for the corrective measures. So these are the 10 is these 10 are the advantages of accounting. As we know that accounting is work on the predetermined principle and rules, and because of the changing in the society and time, we can see that there are the some limitation of accounting also, and that we are going to see next. Limitation of accounting. In that very first is a non-financial transaction. As we know that in accounting we are writing only financial transaction. In the definition of accounting also there is a characteristic that accounts writing only financial transaction. So in the accounting we are not writing non-financial transaction. That means the value of that transaction cannot be count in the money, that we are not recording in the books of account, but we are just writing only books of account for the financial transaction, that is purchase, sales, purchase of asset or income, expenditure, etc. But there are some non-financial transactions that also affect the business. Let's say the example of that is a loyalty of the employee or loyalty of the other person, that is also mean lot to the business, but that we are not writing in the books of account. So non-financial transaction that is also affect the business, that we are not writing in the books of account. That is the biggest limitation of accounting. The second limitation is accounting assume that the value of the money is stable, but in reality and practicality we all knows that because of inflation there is a value of the money is keep changing, but accounting assume that the value of the money is stable. So that is the second limitation of accounting. As we bought the asset before 5 years at rupees 50,000, we are assuming that we can replace that asset now with the 50,000 only. But when we are going to buy the same asset, we can come to know that we are paying more than 50,000. So that is the another limitation of accounting. The third limitation is in historical transaction. As we discussed before, that when we are writing books of account, the transaction has been done and we are writing books of account for the past. So accounting is a writing of the history. We are writing books of account for the historical data. So whatever the history is there, that is we are writing. So that is the third limitation. But as we know that from the history only we can forecast the future, so that is needed to write the books of account for the historical data. The fourth limitation is avoidance of market value. Whenever we are buying asset, that asset we are recording in the books of account for the first price only. As we know that the price of that asset is increasing day by day. But when we are writing books of account, we are avoiding market value of that asset and we are just writing that asset at only cost price. So avoidance of market value is the another limitation of accounting. Number fifth is the use of estimate. In accounting, as we know that we are following some principle and rules. Sometimes some calculation we are doing on the estimates, that are bad debts, bad debt reserve. That calculation we are doing on the estimates. So here, my dear students, maybe you don't know the term bad debt and bad debt reserve. Bad debt means that the money we are not going to get from the debtors, and bad debt reserve means the provision for that. That bad debts and bad debt reserve and other terminology we are going to discuss in our upcoming video. So for now, just try to understand that whenever we are giving goods on credit, some debtors, they are not giving us money, that is called bad debts. And for that, whatever provision we are doing, that is called bad debt reserve. So here in the accounting, we are making some estimate to calculate bad debts and bad debts reserve, that is on the estimate. That estimate sometimes can be proved wrong because of the skill of the writer. When the accounts has been written with the someone, that estimate can prove wrong. So if the estimate is wrong, then account is also going to be proved wrong. So that is the next limitation of accounting, that estimates, when we are writing with the help of estimates. Number six is a dual standard. So here, when we are writing books of account, at the end of writing books of account, we are preparing our final account. In final account, as we know, as we discussed before, that we are preparing three accounts called trading account, profit and loss account, and balance sheet. So trading account and profit and loss account, we are writing at actual cost, or what expenditure or income we have incurred or done. So in that, we are writing at our actual cost. But when we are preparing balance sheet, that balance sheet we are preparing at our historical cost. So that are the two dual standards for writing one accounting. So accounting is done on dual standard. So that is the next limitation of accounting. As we know that there are some limitation of accounting, but apart from that, the accounting is very useful to the business owner, government, and other stakeholders. Besides all the limitation of accounting, there is a need of the accounting, as we know that accounting is very useful. So accounting nowadays is developed as a language of a business, and accounting also prove as a science. And as we know that accounting is also an art, because each and every person can show his own art in the writing accounts.